Good morning and a warm welcome to the students of Smt.R.S.Kalaria, Rajshree School, English Medium, Junagadh. My name is Rajshree Lakhani and today we are going to study about a very interesting topic of social about cities, that is India, challenges and solution. Now, we got independence on 15th August 1947. During that time and before that time, our situation was very critical. We were not able to just speak anything in front, express our ideas, opinion, thoughts in front of the others, because we were the slaves during the early ages when Britishers were in our country, India. But overall, Gandhiji was always saying that we, the Indians, are always giving the chance to the European countries to rule in our country, India. The reason behind, we are making behind the unity, integrity and to maintain brotherhood in our country, India. And the reason behind all these low points is the superstition, blindness. Now, we are in the 21st century. Our external development is completely overall. We have developed a lot. But still also, the internal development is lagging behind. Still also, in many parts of our country, India, we are having different type of superstitions, blind beliefs. We are more from the external side, we have developed a lot. But still also, in the internal development, we are lagging behind. And that is our thoughts, our ideas. We are still not developing a lot. So let us start with the points here. In modern times, we are in the 21st century. The external needs of development have changed, but the internal needs of development have more or less remained the same. We are still in many parts of our country, India. Many of the people are orthodox. They are still believing on the superstition. They are still following the evil customs which were before the independence. Now here, honesty, moral values, awareness towards the rights and duties of a citizen, still also many of the rights, fundamental rights which has been given by the constitution of our country, India, we are not getting it. Along with the rights, we are not following the duties which are allotted to the citizen. Traffic awareness, sensitivity towards environment, day by day. For our development, we are just destroying the environment. That is a very low point from our side. Have not developed as much as the material we are getting from material. Day by day, the material is developing a lot. But still also, the internal part, the internal development is as much as the external development. To improve all these things, institution of the local self-government, educational institution or NGOs have played a vital role in ensuring the social and professional development of the nation. So all this part of the government, the institution is working out as when our country, India, got independence from the hands of the British on 15th August 1947. Our India was being divided into 562 princely states. So during that time, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, along with all the prominent leaders, promised the people of our country, India, that in any of the way they are going to just ensure the rights and duties to the people of India. And because of that only, we, now the people are in the center of the government, for the people, by the people and to the people. But it is a damn sure thing we are developing from the external side, but still also due to our activities, our internal development is not as same as the external development. Now let us study about the classification of the challenges which is being faced by our country, India. Now there are four problems which we are. They are the internal and the external problems which independent, before the independence and after the independence, as we were not so much educated, we were not a lot about the small family, a happy family planning. Apart from that, for just believing the social customs, blind beliefs, this particular orthodox thinking, we were just having overpopulation in our country, India. So here, for any of the nations, independence. coffee or almonds. So this all things, a breakfast is needed, a food, a water is needed. So in which the particular which is a necessity for each and every human being to be used. In that particular thing, when the particular rise in the price is hindered, that is known as inflation. So digital commodities, for example, a car is not a necessity for each and every human being which is living on the surface of the earth, but the water, the food, the basic commodities which is almost necessary for each and every human being to be used. In that particular every commodity, when the price is rising, that is known as the inflation. A price rise in the commodities of daily use for tea, coffee, or breakfast, we can say for our cereals, pulses, oil. When this particular rising of the price is being created an adverse effect on the human life. So here, inflation causes stress for common man and it becomes tough for a middle class people with limited income to manage the basic expenses. So it is a basic problem for the poor people, the middle class people.
Yeah.
are deprived from all these opportunities is the BPL cut is being provided to the people, poor people, so that they can get also all the facilities which is being provided by the government. So here the next topic for the internal problems is the corruption. Nowadays, before the independence and now also after the independence, the great hindrance for the development of the nation, for the society, for the country is the corruption. During the early ages when the European countries came to our country India, the French, the Portuguese, whosoever, Britishers, whosoever came to our country India during that time, we, our people are not the enemy of one another. We were always having the intention to just have our problems to the other country. So here the corruption is an important role which is the hindrance for the development of the nation. Now here corruption in simple terms means lack of integrity or honesty. Most probably in our country India there are three organs of the government, that is legislature, executive and judiciary. Judiciary is always kept away from the work of the legislature and executive, so that judiciary is not being pressurized from the part of the legislative and executive. So here how the corruption is being carried out, use of a position of trust for dishonest gain. It means dishonest behavior by those in positions of power such as the managers or the government officials. So here most probably the corruption is mostly done by the people who are securing the post in our particular country. So the particular options for the corruption are, corruption can include giving or accepting bribes, Mr. Deha, and to take, giving and accepting bribe from the people, or and inappropriate gifts. Apart from the currency, apart from the money, they are giving different gifts for carrying out their work in an easy way. Double dealings, many a time the powerful people have the options that may, as there are many of the people who are having the double dealing under the table transaction. Many manipulating election also, it is being done in our country. Many a time there is a change is being done in the election. Diverting funds, many a time it is being seen in our country that a fund is being allotted for the progress of the nation, for the development of the nation. So many a time the funds are being misused by the people who are having the powerful purpose, laundering money and defrauding investor. So here, as the corruption in our country India, as already I said you, that before the independence and still also in 21st century, the hindrance on the development of the nation is the corruption. So what are the effects of the corruption? That is violation of the human rights, the fundamental rights, which is being given by the government to us. But many a time, as the powerful people are having their posts and they are misusing that, the human rights are always being snatched away, violated by the people of the powerful post. The second one, hindrance on to the development of the nation. As day by day we are able to see that corruption is increasing day by day. This is the major problem for the development of the nation, and because of that only our India is still the developing nation, not the developed nation. Deterioration of the moral values. Many a time we have seen that many of the people are following the path of truth and non-violence. They are following the moral values, but as they are being pressurized with the corruption, they are just leaving their moral values. Inflation, already we have discussed in the explanation that a basic necessities due to the corruption hoarding is being increasing. This creates an inflation. Lack of trust in law. Already I have said you that legislator and executive India to stop the particular making and giving of the prime and production from our company India, so that more and more development should be there for the development of the nation. Now let us study about the next topic of the internal problem, that is unemployment. Now we by day, introduction of the technology. Now we are having the latest technology in each and every aspect of our life. So here, introduction of technology in the modern times has added to the burning problem of unemployment. Machines have replaced the men and it has resulted into unemployment. Now day by day, during the early ages, the importance of the work of the human being was more compared to the machinery, because during the early ages the technology was not at its peak. But nowadays we are able to see that computers, machines have replaced the work of the human being. Now comparing with the calculation of the human being, the computers are working a lot. Comparing with the human work, we are working 10 times more than the common human being. Apart from that, day by day, in the agriculture purposes also, we are able to see the development, the usage of the machinery instead of the labor work. And because of that only, many a time we are able to see that in the urban area, in the metro cities, the population is increasing, and in the rural areas, in the villages, towns, the particular population is decreasing. And the reason behind that is, in the rural area, in the village area, the people, the labor, as they are very less educated, they are moving towards the agriculture work to just earn their livelihood, to earn their livelihood. But many a time, nowadays, the agriculture have also adopted the latest technology machinery, and because of that only, the people are, the village people, the rural people are moving to the urban areas, the metro cities, for the living their livelihood, to earn the money in the industry they are moving. Now here, education has increased and expanded its horizon. Comparing with the early ages before independence, the Indians were not so much educated, but after the independence we come to realize the importance of the education. So we by day, now it is a good point, a very positive point, that our education is increasing at its peak in our country India. But in the same way, the employment opportunities have increased at an equal rate, and so the unemployment has increased. The people are very much educated, but due to the more and more usage of the machinery, the technology, many a time machines and computers have replaced the work of the people, and that creates the unemployment. Now here, a person who is about 18 years of age and is willing and capable to do work, does not get work, is called an unemployed person. Many a time we have seen that we have got the degree, a very, we can say a very capable degree to work in the surrounding, but then also many a time we are not getting that opportunity, we are considered in the category of the unemployed person. Now here, measures are being given many a time, as people are not getting the employment opportunity, the government is working out to carry out the problem for the unemployment. Now here, what should be done by the government to sort out the problem of unemployment? The option, the particular solution for this idea, shelter for the economically backward people, the people who are not getting the facility for the home, the government should provide them free education. Already we have discussed in the previous topic that government is providing free and compulsory education from the age of 6 to 14 years. So free education, pure drinking water, major issue, as water is uncountable in the world, in the country, but then also pure and good. And we can say that the terrorists are belonging to any of the country. They are the group of people who are always having the intention to just have a hindrance in the progress of any of the nation. It can either be India, America, Africa, wherever the attack is being done. That creates a great damage to the progress of the nation, and along with the attack for the progress of the nation, it creates a great damage to the peace, brotherhood and unity of any of the particular nation. Their intention was never is created or being a good. They are the group of people who want their to have willing to kill anyone without any reason, and most probably in the terrorist attack, most probably the common people, the we can see a very a group of the people who are innocent always getting hurt by the terrorist attack. Now, terrorism is a challenge for any of the country. We can say that this is only the problem to our country India, but whosoever is a part of the globe, is a part of the world, each and every country is having the same challenge to sort out the terrorism for the world. Now, what should be done to solve this terrorism?
Thank you, and have a nice day.